In the last video, many of you guys asked for a CapCut vector tutorial. And by the way, thank you for your support. But I didn't want to make just any vector tutorial. First of all, because I am not a pro graphic editor. And second of all, I guess you are just like me. You just want to know enough to be able to use the power of vectors to make your videos in CapCut. So in this guide, I'm gonna cover the essentials to start using vectors in CapCut. Where to get them, how to operate them, and what you can do with them in CapCut. For this episode, I prepared a short cheesy animation just to show you real examples and how you can do it step by step.
Here is the story. Not so far away in a busy city, most people live their busy life during the day. Go to work, come back from work, things like that. When the night comes, everyone is asleep like babies. Everyone? No. There's a small YouTuber who is making sure their viewers get the vectors in CapCut tutorial that they want. So this little animation, although very cheesy, will contain as much examples as possible of what you can do with vectors.
Yes.
You know what you did?
Again, don't pay attention to the poor scenario. The goal is to share some keys to operate vectors on CapCut. And there are plenty to look at in this example. But why are vectors so useful for CapCut editors? Well, as you probably know, a vector is infinitely better than an image in terms of quality. Here you have the same picture. One in vector, and one in high-resolution JPEG. Let's try to zoom in on this star in the background. See? Pixels start to pop up. And this is a high-resolution image, mind you. But when you zoom in on the vector image, you never lose quality, no matter how much you zoom in. And that's because it's composed of mathematical shapes, perfect to infinity. And the difference is very notable, especially when you want to zoom in specific spots on your videos. The resolution of a PNG export can go up to 160,000 pixels. I think it covers any zoom you'd want in CapCut, right? And that's not it. A vector image is also composed of layers you can manage separately. All you need to do is to go into a vector editor and export each object you want as a separate PNG image. We'll get to that in a moment. And you have an image with elements you can control, with keyframes for example, or use to do some cool parallax movement animations, or simply use them in the creative way you'd like. Suit yourself. And another cool thing about vectors, there's no limit for your imagination compared to a stock photo where your choice is limited. With vectors, you can find basically any scenery or character you can think of. So, where to get these bad boys? Many sites offer free vectors for download, but I would definitely recommend freepik.com. And when you get the subscription, you get access to even more options and unlimited downloads. I use exclusively this one. You could try searching for alternative sites. But believe me, either they'll have less options or they'll be overpriced. I'm saving you time. So, for my example, I went onto Freepik and searched for elements. I typed in city cartoon and browsed in the different sceneries, characters, and assets I would need for my little project. When searching for elements, make sure to pick ones with the same style. Picking assets from the same author is often a good solution. Also, always make sure to check the file format. Vector files will either be SVG, EPS, or AI. So, for my little scene, I chose these vectors. A city skyline, a neighborhood at day and at night, some other files for people and vehicles, my character's room. I also downloaded a character in different positions and expressions. There are many like this on Freepik. And his little cat, also in different positions. Okay, now that you have all your assets, how to operate them? Now here are a couple of keys you will need for Illustrator. And also in some free tools if you don't have an Adobe subscription. But I've got to tell you, it's way more comfortable in Illustrator. You open up your vector file and can go through the layers with the double click. The double click will be your best friend. You can also browse through the layers on the right panel and use the little eye to locate the objects. But I prefer the double click. Double click until you get the object you want. Copy it, double click outside the object, and paste it. You can clean up unwanted elements by simply double clicking and deleting. Right click on it and select export. Your vector is now in PNG format. If you need a higher resolution, simple. Scale up your vector and export it again. Do this while holding shift to keep the original ratio. Another cool thing you can do is pick colors. Let's say, for example, I want to turn off these lights. Click on this second arrow here. It will allow to select the shape directly. Select the window, make sure you select the right shape. it will be highlighted. And pick the color of a dark window. And there you go. Do this in a sequence of 10 shots, and you get a cool effect. You can also play with the traffic lights. Use the same technique. Another great thing to do is just playing around with the objects to create animated characters. For example, we can create the blinking of the cat's eyes by changing the eyes. Double-click until you get the open eyes and replace them with the closed eyes and export to PNG. You can also animate the cat licking itself by doing a rotation of the head. Create 6, 7, or 8 frames by smoothly increasing the rotation angle, and you got yourself an animated cat in CapCut. Same thing with the character. Interchange the different body parts to create a character in motion. Same technique. Select and place the body parts in a good fashion and export each one to a separate PNG file. Now, if you don't have Illustrator, you can go with some free alternatives like InkScape or PhotoPea, but they don't have a double-click feature. So you'll have to go through the different layers on the right panel and use the little eye to locate the objects you want. Once you do that, go to File then Export to PNG for each object you want. And now, the fun part. How to put this in motion in CapCut. Once you have your images and frames ready, start by inserting your layers in the way you want. If you want, for example, to animate a vehicle, you do that, of course, with keyframes. But to give it a more natural look, right-click on it and select Show Keyframe Animation. Select each keyframe and give it the curve, depending on the action. We can make this car accelerate or decelerate, depending on the curve you choose. You can also make a character walk in the same way, but for the natural look, go for the rebounce effect. Adjust the strength, speed, and size of the effect to go along with the desired motion. Many effects in CapCut can fit along well with motion, and those curves we just used can be used in some very interesting ways. They can give a natural feel to real-life motions. Let's say you want to make this ball bounce naturally. If you do it just with keyframes, you'll get something like this. Not very natural. But when you apply the right curves, it's something else. So we want the ball to slow down when it reaches up and bounce fast when it hits the ground. Select each keyframe and apply the auto curve button. Extend those handles to get the right curve. You can also play with scaling down to get the ball further away while it bounces. If you want to create parallax animations, also very simple. Insert your different layers and give them different sizes. Then play around keyframes and scales to give them opposite scaling. You can also use keyframe curves to give it a better look. And the last tool you'll need, animate those still frames you created. Very simple. Place them on the timeline and play with the length of each frame. In this example, the blink is shorter than open eyes. We place a sequence of 2 or 3 blinks. And try to copy-paste your previous elements to get the same size and position. Test out everything, adjust if necessary, and create a compound clip. You can use this principle to animate any still frames you create with vectors. You just gotta spend the time you need to adjust the frames for a natural look. Now, there are so many things you can do with these things on CapCut. You'll find out very quickly that the limit will be your imagination and not the available assets or possibilities. You just have to give it the time and effort to try and master the keys I shared with you. Hope these insights will be helpful to you in your creative path. If you like them, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and share with us your thoughts in the comments section. Until next time, cheers!